Victoria records its biggest daily increase of locally transmitted virus this year, but the state's health authorities are confident lockdown measures are working, with most new cases quarantined for their entire infectious period.
This shows that our combination of measures that have put together in our public health toolkit are starting to work.
All 26 cases are linked to current outbreaks. One attended the busy Paran markets last weekend, leaving the entire site shut down today and 900 shoppers put on notice. They'll join over 18,000 others in isolation.
We need you to go into isolation immediately. You will be released by the Department of Health. Please do not release yourself on the grounds that you think you feel okay.
43,000 got tested yesterday and over 14,000 received a vaccination. The state's chief health officer joining the ranks of the fully vaccinated this morning.
Job done. Congratulations.
Quite relieved to get fully vaccinated today. Looking forward to what that means for me.
Measures to reach some of the most vulnerable launched in Melbourne, with pop-up vaccination clinics for those experiencing homelessness and disadvantage.
People are nice here. You don't have to wait in line.
I want to tell the other people, please come forward and get vaccine and save yourself, save community and save the country.
Despite today's spike in numbers, state health authorities say a wide net has been cast around the current outbreak. And while it's still too early to guarantee the current lockdown will end on time Tuesday night, they're feeling optimistic.
We're winning the race. It's a question of just keeping going so hard to the finish line.
South Australia's outbreak now stands at 14 after two new cases were recorded, a brother and sister who attended the Tenafeet Creek Winery and have been in isolation since Monday.
We're not out of the woods yet. There's still a huge number of test results to come in.
Over 17,000 swabs were taken yesterday, with today's staffing numbers bolstered after reports of 14-hour wait times. But health authorities say not enough primary close contacts are getting tested. Just over half identified from the Greek restaurant cluster and a quarter linked to the winery have come forward.
Because of these being a high-risk location, what we're doing at the moment is moving all of those people into the Medi-Hotel facility.
Around 100 are expected to be transferred in coming days, some expressing concern over the potential of another virus leak from an Adelaide Medi-Hotel. SA Health telling SBS, we continuously review our Medi-Hotel practices to mitigate risk and ensure the safety of staff and guests. Changes were made across the Medi-Hotels in December 2020 to improve ventilation in rooms and corridors.
Those people are at least the same, if not slightly higher risk of getting COVID than some of our international travellers at the moment.
WA bumping up its border restrictions with the state, meaning only South Australians with an exemption will be permitted to travel into the West. Abby Dinham, SBS World News.